On today's episode, I have a really very interesting person that I am sure that you're going to really benefit a lot from what he has to share. His name is Bill Lanting, and he's America's Allergist. Now, before I actually start talking to him, let me tell you how I actually met. We were in a hotel, and we went down there to the buffet for breakfast. I poured myself coffee. I actually got some milk on my coffee, put my sugar, get it all nicely prepared, then turn around to take something else, and then when I turn around, my coffee cup was gone. And guess what has happened? Dr. Bill has actually taken my cup away, by mistake, of course. However, it was great because, of course, that got us to connect, and I was extremely interested about what he was doing. And we were having a really nice conversation, and I just was very, very impressed by what he's doing, but also by his personality on stage. So, Dr. Bill, welcome to the show.
Very good. Glad to be here, Ernesto.
Yeah, it is really great to have you here. I mean, this show is about resources, but you know, not only about internet resources. I mean, I sometimes share health resources or travel resources or any kind of other different resources. So, can you tell us a little bit of what you're doing?
Well, my thing is that I have a private practice of allergy and asthma in Colorado, and we make people feel fantastic. Our theory is that people should recognize they have allergies, feel fantastic, and do something about them. And we can give them a wonderful life with no symptoms and no problems. So what I want to do is take this philosophy that's on a local level at my regular private practice and bring it national to the nation to tell people you shouldn't have to live with eye symptoms and runny, stuffy nose and cough, breathing issues, headaches, sore throat. All these things usually come from allergies. So what we like to do is inform people, yes, it is allergies. This is something you have, something you can do something about, live a wonderful life and feel great and feel fantastic. What I was telling Ernesto is, you know, our patients, we don't even want them to feel good, because good is not acceptable. Great is acceptable. If you can feel fantastic, all you have to do is figure out, yes, it's allergies, and you can do something about it. And that's what my DVD programs of America's Allergist at americasallergist.com are all going to be about.
Can you tell us a little bit about allergies? Because I know a lot of people about allergies, and they just feel that there's nothing that they can do. So I want to make sure that there is a that you actually share some stuff that they can go and do and find out so that they can just get rid of those allergies.
Well, people with allergies, first of all, feel horrible because of the symptoms that are produced, but also that they have them. People feel like they're defective. There's something wrong with them. Just the opposite. Our immune system is there to fight viruses, bacteria, and things like that. But a special part of the population, one-third, one out of three people, has the ability to use this part of the immune system, IgE, and these allergy cells to fight parasites. We don't have to do that anymore, but the system still exists within us. So what happens is that this system now needed to do something, so it picked up on foreign proteins, like dog, cat, grasses, weeds. So what happened is people all of a sudden would go like this, and they inhale these different allergens. The body goes, oh, I have to protect, that's my job. And so what happens is that it produces a chemical to help fight this foreign protein, that's histamine. And it's the histamine that causes itchy, red eyes, discharge, stuffy nose, mucus, postnasal drip, or cough, throat clearing, sore throat, nausea, even headaches and sinusitis, and breathing problems, which leads to asthma. All that coming from allergies. So it's got all these different things going on, but people should never feel defective. The only problem is that people feel they have to live with it, mainly because they just always have their life. They don't think there's anything they can do about it. The regular doctors don't bring it up. I find, though, it's also the family curse, because it's genetic. Mom has it, grandma, the uncle, grandfather, and so they go, oh, I'm supposed to live with this just like everybody else. There's nothing else I can do, I shouldn't do. But our thing is like, no, recognize that there's something there, it's allergies, and do something about it to live a great life.
Why is it? What's the story? Why aren't doctors giving you the, saying, well, you know, I mean, as you were saying, I mean, doctors are not recognizing all these kinds of things that you are recognizing. What's the story behind all that?
I think it's a problem in the training of doctors in medical school and even residencies, especially primary care. They want to know about the heart and cardiology and the lungs and the kidneys, and they don't see the importance of allergy, but yet it affects one-third of all their patients. And if they don't know to look for it, if they don't know there could be problems from allergies and all the things it causes, they can't help people. So if they don't know what to look for, they can't figure it out. And also, the patients don't always know they could do something about it, so they don't bring it up to their doctor. They don't go, let's talk about my cholesterol, my blood pressure, because they think they have to live with the allergy symptoms, when actually, no, it's something they could do about. But I think it's one of the things that we have to encourage our medical students and residents to take a rotation for 1 or 2 weeks with us to learn how they can serve a third of their patients. They can make them feel better, or at least they recognize their problems and send them to a specialist, an allergist, immunologist, to make them feel fantastic.
Fantastic. I think the information is great, Dr. Bill. Where can we send our viewers? I mean, we have about 3,500 viewers live on the show, and later on we will be, of course, having about 5,000 people this week actually watching this show. So I am sure that many of them would be very interested to find more about you. Where can we send them?
If you go to americasallergist.com, americasallergist.com has videos on our front page and throughout, and different bits of information. One of the things, 7 things nobody will tell you about allergies. All this information for free, just to inform people about, is it allergies and what you can do about it, and how to get more information to feel great with allergies. That's the whole thing. You don't want to be good, you want to be great. You have to be informed, and I think our website will give everybody all the information that they need.
That is fantastic. So, Dr. Bill, I really appreciate you for being on the show. And guys, now I think it's time that we go to our next section, which is one app a day keeps boredom away. Thank you.